Hi, hello, namaste. In today's session, we'll be seeing a concept called as curl. If you remember, in electrostatics, the Gauss law was applied on a differential volume element. So we had applied the Gauss law on a differential volume element to explain or to develop a concept of divergence. In the similar manner, in magnetostatics, we'll be using the application of Ampere circuit law to on a differential surface element to explain the concept of curl. Okay, so what we do is we'll be considering a differential surface as seen in this particular diagram. I'll place a differential surface del x and del y. Okay, del x dot del y or del x and del y is the plane on xy plane, which is nothing but I have some unknown current or some current is flowing in my three-dimensional space. Because of that current, there is a magnetic field produced at the center of this particular point P. Okay, at this particular point P, I have a magnetic field produced because of some unknown current that is flowing there. So what we do is, the magnetic field that is created here can be calculated by using this particular expression, that is vector h can be defined as h of x at the origin in the direction ax cap plus h of y at the origin in the direction y cap plus h of z at the origin calculated by az cap. So the current that caused this magnetic field can also be defined as jx, or here I am specifying the current density. Okay, jx into ax cap plus jy of ay cap plus jz of az cap. So these are the total current density and the magnetic field at that point P. So this current density has caused the magnetic field at that point P to exist. So what we do is, I have applied this Ampere circuit law to this closed path so that I can calculate my H at that particular point. So what I do is, I'll be traversing through this closed path. The path here is 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, I'll be taking this closed path 1, 2, 3, 4 and back to 1, and I'll be calculating the magnetic field intensities at each point. So according to the right hand thumb rule, the current, if the current is in the z direction, so if I have a current that is flowing in the z direction, so the magnetic field should be revolving around this particular path, right? It should be revolving in this path. If you take a wire and hold it in your right hand where the thumb shows the direction of current, then your fingers, which is curled, will be showing the magnetic field. So the same thing. Now what I do is, I'll move along the path 1 to 2. So for 1 to 2, I am moving in this direction. From 1 to 2, I'm traversing. Okay, while doing that, I'm calculating the magnetic field intensity at that particular point. So you know, Ampere circuit law is defined as closed loop H dot dl, which is equal to the current enclosed. Or in our electrostatics, we also know current is nothing but integral of the current density times the surface integral of ds, right? So this is how I'm trying to relate. So what I do now is, I am only solving this LHS or the left hand side. So for that, I have to first calculate what is H. So if I want to calculate the H, how is my H flowing? H is flowing in the Y axis, or it is flowing in the Y direction, right? So I can define this H as H of Y dot AY cap. So that is my H vector. Similarly, the traverse path or the length that I have traveled from 1 to 2 is what? Del y in the direction what? A of y cap. So if I solve for h dot dl. This can be given as h of y dot ay cap times del y dot ay cap again. Y cap dot y cap will be equal to 1. So y dot y cap dot y cap, or similar axis dot product, will be equal to 1, which we all know. This particular equation becomes h of y, the intensity of magnetic field in y direction, times del y. Okay, this is my first expression that I have derived. But what is the intensity of hy? What is the intensity of hy? How can I define the intensity of hy along the path 1 to 2? If I want to define the hy, I can actually define it over here. Hy can be defined as, so if you take this path, I'm just trying to redraw it. This is my origin. Okay, at origin, what is my hy? At origin, hy naught is the y component of the magnetic field at origin, plus what is the distance at which I'm traversing now. I'm traversing at a distance, so the whole distance of this was delta x, and since it is a midpoint, from midpoint to here it will be delta x over 2. So plus delta x over 2 is the path where I have traversed, and along this path, okay, along this path I am now moving in the direction, like I am moving from 1 to 2. So what is the rate of change of magnetic field intensity of y as I move in h of x? So how is my magnetic field from origin? It is changing when I come towards the path, or the path 1 to 2. So that is what this intensity of hy is defined over. So substituting this in this expression, I'll be getting, so I'll be doing the substitution. So what I'm doing is I'm substituting here. So my h dot dl for path 1 to 2 can be simply written as h of y naught plus delta of x divided by 2 times del of h y by del of x, the whole multiplied by del of y. Okay, let me call this as equation A. Similarly, now I have to solve for the path 2 to 3. So now I am trying to move in this direction. I am again calculating the magnetic field intensity in this direction. So for path 2 to 3, again I have to calculate h dot dl. Okay, so what is h over here? If you see this, h is now in the direction delta x, h of x, which is opposite to my x axis, right? I'm moving in the reverse direction of my positive x axis. So I can write this as h of x times minus ax cap. Okay, and dl is the differential length, the length that I have traveled. So length cannot be negative, so it is delta x is the length I have taken, in which direction it is ax cap. So solving for h dot dl, the same concept holds good here. Ax cap and ax cap will be 1, and the answer will be minus h of x times delta x. Okay, I've just cut it short. I'm not writing the complete thing. X cap, this x cap dot x cap will be equal to 1. This negative will be multiplied, so minus h of x dot delta x. But what is h of x here? What is the intensity of magnetic field here? If you see this h of x, if I want to get the h of x content over here, I have to take from the origin. So at the origin, h of x was given as h of x naught plus, now I am moving in this direction, right? So I have to move what distance? It is delta y by 2. Since delta y is the total length in y, I have to move delta y by 2 from the origin. So plus delta y by 2, and as I move from this origin point to the path, how is my magnetic field varying. The magnetic field with respect to x is varying with respect to y. So it is delta H of x divided by delta y. So this is the intensity of H of x that is varied. So substituting this in this expression, I can simply write H dot dl as negative times H of x 0 plus delta y over 2 tau of x by tau of y times delta x. This is my equation B. I'll call this as equation B. So I got for two different paths. Now I have to take the third path, that is 3 to 4. So the similar manner for path 3 to 4, I have to calculate now H dot dl. So H dot dl, if I calculate H, H is now nothing but I am moving in this direction, which is nothing but the negative y direction, because y axis is in this fashion. I am going against that y axis. So what will be my H? H can be defined as H of y times minus a y cap, and dl can be written as delta y times a y cap, right? So solving for this, I'll be ending up at what? It can be written as y cap dot y cap will be equal to 1. So the whole solution will be minus h of y dot del y. This is the solution for this. Am I not for this? Pardon me, that is not h. The solution is for h dot dl. But what is this h of y in that path? For the path 3 to 4, what is h of y? How can I define h of y? For that path, h of y can be defined as, so see, for example, in this path, now I'm taking in this path, how can I define h of y? With respect to the origin, with respect to this origin, at origin, my magnetic field intensity was given as h of y naught plus, okay, plus, I have to move in this direction, right? If I have to move in this direction, what is that distance I have to travel there? It is, the total path is delta x, but it is delta x over 2, but it is in the reverse direction. That means it is negative delta x. I have to take negative delta x by 2 steps to go to that part. So I can write this, it is not plus now. So it should be negative. So it is minus delta x over 2. So I have taken back step. So if this is a coordinate system, I'm going back, right? So it is minus delta x by 2 times my magnetic field intensity in the y direction changing with respect to the x. So it is again rate of change of magnetic field intensity with respect to y, or the y direction magnetic field, how it is getting changed with respect to x. So this is the intensity, and substituting this equation here, I can write the H dot dl as the whole minus H of y naught minus del x over 2 deva H of y by delta x times del y. Okay, this I'll call it as equation C. Then for the final path, okay, for path 4 to 1, I'll be directly solving this. Hope this is not needed. So if I see this particular path from 4 to 1, it is going in the direction of x direction. So I can simply write it as h of x dot ax cap, and dl can be written as delta x dot ax cap. So h dot dl for this path is simply h of x dot delta x. So now the intensity can be calculated. H of x for this path can be calculated like at the origin h of x naught, and now from the origin what is the path I am traversing? I have to take this route. So from the origin I have to go in the negative direction, so it is minus delta y by 2. To that path it is minus delta y by 2, hence this is minus delta y over 2. And how is my flux changing? My flux is changing by the direction delta y. So substituting this in this particular expression yields me h dot dl can be written as h of x naught minus del of y over 2 delta of hx by delta of y times del x. So I'll call this as equation D. So I've got for the complete path. So what are the equation that I've written over here in white or ABC? So I've completed the whole traverse 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4 and 4 to 5. Okay. So after getting this, I have to solve for the complete expression. So adding, because I know it is closed surface integral of h dot dl is nothing but here it is 1 to 2 plus 2 to 3 plus 3 to 4 plus 4 to 1 of my equation h dot dl. So I have to do this particular thing. So what I do is I'm adding a, b, c and d. I have to add all this expressions. So if I do that, okay, I'll try to do it in this part. My a expression was, okay, this is the a expression, h of y naught plus del x by 2, I guess so, del x by 2, del of h y, del of x. Times del of y. Okay, this is the first addition part. Similarly, plus this one b. Okay, b is negative, so h of x naught. So okay, so it is minus h of x naught, plus del of y over 2 times del of h of x over del of y. Okay, minus del of Okay, great. So I have taken all the expressions now. So once I try to iterate this expression and I try to solve it, you can see this term and this term will be getting cancelled off because it is positive and this is negative. Similarly, this term and this term will be getting cancelled off. So the final expression, I'll be taking now the final expression. So final expression of my closed h dot dl can be very much simplified as del x del y times, since it is all added up, half and half will be added up, so you'll be getting del x and del y. It is del of h of y over del of x minus del of h of x over del of y. So this will be my equation 1. Okay, I'll call this as equation 1, a numerical equation. So according to Ampere circuit law, I know the closed line integral of h dot dl is given by the current enclosed, but the current enclosed, as I said, the current enclosed is nothing but what? It is nothing but for this particular path or the closed path that we had considered, I can call it as J of Z, because I said already the current is flowing in the Z direction for this part. Okay, so J of Z into what is the surface? It is del X del Y, right? So this is the current density and this is the area of that particular surface. So using this equation 1, and I'll call this as equation 2, I can solve for the Ampere circuit law expression. So for solving for that Ampere circuit law, what I do is h dot dl, the whole thing comes over here, del x del y times del of hy by del of x minus del hx over del y is equal to jz del x del y. So taking this to the LHS of both the equations, or dividing the complete equation by del x del y, I'll be ending up at h dot dl over del x del y is equal to del hy over del x minus del hx over del y. So which is nothing but the current density jz. So I have found out the current density jz here. So if I say this, the accurate result for this closed path, if the closed path del x and del y, if I apply a limit over here, so if the limit, okay, I'll take this color, if the limit del x and del y tends to 0, that means the path which we had considered, the path which we had considered on the xy plane, will be getting shrink to 0. So that as it gets shrink to 0, I will be getting the magnetic field intensity at that point at the origin. So this is the current density in the direction of z, because I said the current will be flowing here. Because of this current, there is a flux that is created, hence we took this path, right? So this is for one particular plane, for xy plane. I can say this is for xy plane. Similarly, I am not going to solve for the other two planes. If I consider for yz plane, yz plane means to say I should be considering the current to be flowing in the, okay, this is y and this is z plane. So this is a plane, the current will be flowing in my x direction. So because of this current, there is a magnetic field created at the origin of this point. So again, I have to take this Ampere circuit law, and if I hold it through my right hand, this is how the magnetic flux being created, again I have to solve for the whole path. So after solving, my equation for this path can be written as, I'll be directly writing that expression, I'll be not solving for the complete thing. Limit again del y and del z now, because it is yz plane. So this is for yz plane, which will be, if I make it to 10 to 0, I'll be getting h dot dl over del y del z will be equal to, what are the two components that it will be equal to? It will be equal to del of hz over del of y minus del of hy over del z. If you solve for the expression or the equation, you'll be getting, this is nothing but the current that is flowing in the x direction, jz, the current density in the x direction. Similarly for the zx plane, okay, so I'm considering the plane to be like this now. So for the plane, something like this. So now the current will be, can be thought of flowing in the y direction. So if I say the right hand thumb rule, the magnetic flux again can be represented like this. Again for the whole closed path, if I substitute and solve the equation as we did in the above derivation, it will be something like limit del of x and del of z tending to 0, integral of h dot dl over del x del z will be equal to what? Will be equal to del of h hx by del of z minus del of hz over del of x. So this is going to get you the current density in the y direction. Okay, so in general, this whole three planes, whatever I have done, in general I can actually represent this. Okay, in general I can define this as limit of that surface area, okay, the normal to that surface area which tends to zero. Okay, I'll use this part for the closed integral of h dot dl over that surface, okay, over that surface will be equal to the current in that surface, or the current which is normal to that surface. This is normal components. So this is the expression in general. So by taking this three expression, I'll be calling this three expressions as, say, alpha, beta and gamma. So taking these three expressions in the current expression, so we had seen the current density expression in the very beginning. The current density expression was given as what? Jx in the direction x cap plus jy in the direction ay cap plus jz in the direction az cap, right? So I have already calculated j of x, j of y, j of z. So substituting this expression over here, I can write this as, okay, I'll take two colors. So j of x was defined as del h of z over del of y minus x cap plus yes, finally az cap. So this is the final expression of j, okay? But if you see the expression, in the right hand side. Actually, this right hand side is what the expression for a cross product. So this expression is actually defined as J is equal to curl of vector H. So this is the curl operator. So what is a curl operator? Curl operator is nothing but, I can also write this as delta or del cross H is nothing but my curl operator, which is a expression for Maxwell's equation. This is one of the Maxwell's equation for the Ampere circuit law in the point form, where del cross H will be giving me J. Now you might ask, like, what is a del cross H? If I try to explain you this, okay, this video might be a bit lengthy, but I'll try to write it in short. So del cross H is nothing but, you can consider a matrix where you have AX cap, AY cap, AZ cap. What is a del operator? Del operator is originally the partial derivative with respect to the axis or the coordinates, right? And what is my H vector? H vector was defined as HX, HY, HZ. So if I solve this matrix, I will be getting the right hand side, whatever I have done here. So you can just give a thought and you can try it out. If you solve for this, you'll be getting the whole component in the right hand side, which is nothing but the current density J. So this is a point form of, this is a point form of Ampere circuit law, and this is also the concept of curl. Okay, also the concept of curl. So whenever I say curl of H, curl of anything, okay, curl of A, let me call some function curl of A. Curl of A means to say it is nothing but del cross vector A. Whatever I have, say for example P is equal to curl of A, so P is nothing but del cross A is what the curl operator is. Hope even though I made the video more lengthy today, you have understood the concept. Thanks for listening. If you have any doubts, as usual, please do comment or come in, drop in some text. I'll help you out. Thank you.